Tim Taylor's TV Talk Time. Tim Taylor's TV Talk Time. Richard Simmons is no longer famous. Rick's jacket did not fit the bear. What am I doing? Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Kindle Reviews. Today I'm going to be talking to you about my somewhat newly purchased Lone Peak 4.0s. I'm going to be letting you know just why I chose these over the 3.5s. It's actually kind of a funny story how I ended up with these, so be sure to stay tuned. All right, guys, let's get down to business. First things first, what made me switch up from my previous Adidas Trail Runners to a pair of Altra Lone Peak 4s? Well, one of the first things was this has no open toe box. This one does have an open toe box, which basically is just wider so your toes can spread more, which creates more comfort. And another thing, the Adidas does not have any gaiter attachments on them. Altra has these attachments for the hook up front for your gaiters and also a Velcro attachment in the back. Another big thing was the zero drop platform, which basically means that your heel and your toes are on the same platform, an even platform. Usually most runners like to bulk up the shoes in the back for impact, and your shoe sole is kind of a little bit more of, you know, at an angle. So it's real interesting when you first put these on and you don't feel that. Also, another thing was the popularity of these things seem to be just through the roof. I started out looking at the Altra Temps, which I still think is a pretty cool shoe. However, the more and more research that I did, it all zeroed in on these Lone Peaks. And then I found a new war. Do I choose the Lone Peak 3.5s or do I choose the Lone Peak 4.0s? Well, that's another story, and I'm about to get into that very soon here. Okay, guys, so let's get down to the story. How did I end up with these things? This is where it gets kind of weird. I ordered on Amazon a pair of size 13s, which is what I normally wear, and when I got them in, I had way too much room between the tip of my toe and the end of the shoe, so I ended up sending them back reluctantly and kind of changed my mind. I got the RSMs. When I got them in the mail, they were 12 and a half, but they still seem rather large. And I also noticed the material they were made out of didn't seem like it would have any longevity, especially through brush and prickers. And once that was pierced, the whole shoe's compromised. So as far as spending $160 for that RSM shoe, it just really wasn't intriguing me. So I decided to send those back, and I ended up ordering a pair of Lone Peak 3.5s because I started hearing about this cushion factor difference. I ordered them, I get them in a size 12 this time. Well, I'm so excited I got the 3.5s. I felt like I made the right decision. I slide them on and my toes are touching the tip of the shoe. Oh. This is the third pair of shoes I ordered and they did not fit again. So I was just like, what am I gonna do? I was at the point where I was almost gonna give up and just try a completely different shoe. At that point, I realized I should have done it in the first place. I ended up going to the Northeast Ohio Backpacker Shop in Sheffield, Ohio. Walked in there, let them know on my way there that I was coming there to pick up a pair of 3.5s. They said that they had a blue pair in a 12 and a half left, but they would hold them aside for me, you know, for Alex to come pick up. I open the box and it's a pair of high tops that are black. We decided to go in the back and look at other shoes, and I'm sitting there looking at, you know, what should I get? Should I get these? Maybe I should get the Tips now, you know? And I was like, you know, I feel really embarrassed because I told you my story with the 12 and a half being too big. Give me a pair of 12 and a halves in the 4.0. So he comes back out with these shoes. I slid them on. My feet were finally home. Finally have my pair of Lone Peaks. So let's see what I really like better, the 3.5s or the 4.0s. So before sending my red ones back to Amazon, I decided to do a little test. Now here is that test.
guys, we're running, trying out these Lone Peak 3.5s. They feel pretty good, actually. They're very comfortable. They bend really well. I understand what the break-in period everyone talks about, and that's about it. I mean, there's pretty much, it feels a lot like my Adidas, to be honest with you, but these aren't really what I thought they were, at least in the beginning.
Those were okay, but they just didn't have that range of motion I was looking for. So I went out to test my 4.0s.
This is that ice cold Michelle fight for that white gold. This one for them hood.
Guys, I'm running and these Lone Peak 4s flex with my foot a lot better.
Gotta kiss myself, so pretty. I'm too hot.
So, the Lone Peak 3.5s definitely felt a lot stiffer. However, these Lone Peak 4s, man, it just feels like I'm running barefoot with a little sole strapped to the bottom of my feet. However, the traction on these things on the road are pretty good, given the fact that they're so, you know, made for off-road, but yeah, I definitely like the feel of these a lot better.
Saturday night and we in the spot. Don't believe me, just watch.
In my book, much better. Really didn't even need to break them in. I mean, I hit the ground running really with these things. So, little tip, find an Altra dealer near you and go to the store and get your size fitted. Do not order these online unless you have already previously had a pair and are savvy to Altra's sizing. With that, I want to thank you guys for watching.
And look forward to seeing you on another one.